Solving definite integrals by integration by parts is pretty straightforward. Let's say we have the integral from 0 to 1 of e to the x plus x e to the x dx. So we're going to start just by looking at this as integration by parts. So you might be caught off guard by the fact that we have addition in here and not just a product, because usually we're looking for, you know, u times dv. But we can write this as a product. We can write this as the integral from 0 to 1 of e to the x times the quantity 1 plus x dx. So looking at our formula, we have the integral of u dv equals u times v minus the integral of v du. And now that we have these constants of integration, we need to include these. So the integral from a to b of u dv equals u times v evaluated from a to b minus the integral from a to b of v du. So if we have the integral from 0 to 1 of e to the x times the quantity 1 plus x dx, we still need to find our u and our dv. And experience has shown that typically our dv is going to be our e to the x dx, and our u is going to be the term with the x in it. So in this case, 1 plus x. So finding the derivative of u, we get dx. And finding the integral of dv, we get v equals e to the x. And this time, we won't have a constant of integration because we have a definite integral. So now we have that the integral from 0 to 1 of e to the x times the quantity 1 plus x dx equals u times v, so 1 plus x times e to the x evaluated from 0 to 1 minus the integral e to the x times du, which is dx, from 0 to 1. So we need to find the integral of e to the x dx. And we should know that that integral is e to the x, and we're going to evaluate it from 0 to 1. So we have 1 plus x times e to the x minus e to the x, and this whole thing is being evaluated from 0 to 1. So plugging in 1, we get 1 plus 1 times e to the first minus e to the first minus the whole quantity when we plug in 0, 1 plus 0 times e to the 0 minus e to the 0. So we get 2 times e minus, we'll leave this as a quantity for now. 1 plus 0 is 1. E to the 0 is 1 minus e to the 0 is 1. So 2e minus e leaves us with e, and 1 minus 1 is 0. So we get e minus 0, which is just e.